Hey Glam Fam, Linwood here, and today I'm going to be talking to you about hair texture, what it is, what it isn't, and how it impacts your head of hair. So if you're interested in that, stay tuned, thumbs up if you like it, and be sure to check out my last video by clicking on the eye in the top right corner. Let's dive right in. So I hear a lot about hair texture, and oftentimes people have a tendency to think of hair texture in a totally different way from what it actually is. When people think of texture, usually what they think is like soft, silky versus like more rough. They're looking for a certain feel, but texture is not implicative of the feel of the hair. Texture is actually implicative of the diameter of the hair, and that does impact the hair in many different ways. Now, of course, you've got different aspects of how the hair feels, which do impact certain things, but everything that most people commonly attribute to texture is not quite the same, and it could mean that you're potentially burning your hair, using chemicals that are too strong, or doing things to your hair that you really shouldn't be doing. It may also mean that you need to be trimming more often or less frequently. So let's go ahead and break this down. When you're dealing with texture, texture deals with the size of the strands. So fine texture would be smaller, medium a bit more, and then coarse a bit larger. So to give you a visual illustration, I have three canisters down here. So I've got this one here that represents fine hair, and I want you guys to see the diameter here versus, like, let's say medium here. Now, a fine strand is much thinner. What that means is a fine strand of hair is going to be more prone to being burnt. Especially like if you've seen the videos with the girl like doing the curling wand and her hair came off with the wand, what's going on is she was using a temperature for coarse hair, but she was using it on fine hair and it burned her hair off. It was significantly too high. So what you want to do is turn down your irons. That's number one. Number two, understand that this fabric of hair is more fragile. So getting like soft brushes that bend and move with you, or using a soft paddle brush with flexible bristles, things like that is going to be more beneficial for this hair type. Also make sure with all of these fabrics, but especially with this fabric of hair, that you're detangling from the ends of the hair and working your way on up, because this type of hair is going to be very prone to breaking, to splitting, things like that. It's going to need trimming a bit more often because since it's more thin, it's more prone to breakage. Now, one of the things that you'll want to consider is most heads of hair will have multiple textures on there. So for instance, I have medium texture hair, but all around the edges, my hair is fine, as is the case with most people, even if their hair is coarse. That's why a lot of times you'll notice the edges will tend to stay shorter, they don't tend to grow as longer, they're much more prone to breakage. If you do your hair a lighter color, they always tend to go a shade or two lighter than the rest of it. It's because it's more fine. It much more easily overprocesses, and it can take much less heat without burning it straight or losing curl pattern, things like that. So that being said, always be careful about the amount of heat, the strength of chemicals, or how light of a color, things like that, you're putting on your hair if it's fine, especially around the edges. This is often why I constantly fuss at people about, like, if you're doing a relaxer, you should not be putting it on your edges first. That is the most fine area of most heads. You should be doing it in the area that is the most coarse, and people are often looking at coarse based on curl pattern or based on the feel. That's not what coarse is, okay? Now, fine hair is also much more prone to flyaways and static, so if you're noticing that you have quite a few issues with that, there's a good chance that you have fine hair. At the same time, if you're doing chemicals, I've seen fine hair break from something as simple as a color, especially if you have fine hair that is coily, because now it's going to be a little bit more moisture deficient, and on top of that, it's fine. Dryness causes hair to break really easily. Fine hair also breaks really easily, so it's not exactly a win-win situation. If you have coily hair, like type 4 hair, things like that, and it's fine, you need to treat it with love, care, and respect. Protective styles are going to be your best friend, and you need to do things that are limiting the amount of manipulation you have. If you have straighter hair and it's fine, I would recommend doing more braided styles, heat-free styles like roller sets or braid outs, things like that. Even if you have straight hair, you can still do braid outs for wavy looks, for beachy looks, without having to put heat on your hair on a regular. And I'd also say find ways to wear your hair up a bit more so it's not constantly rubbing against the shoulder, especially if you're wearing rough fabrics like winter sweaters, wool, things like that. It more easily rubs against there and causes split ends. So fine hair, that's the case. medium here. You can use a bit more in terms of temperature, but it does still take a little bit of care. I will say this is most heads. So if you're gonna hear someone say like the average head of hair is, it's typically going to be medium hair. Now just to give you spot of reference again, so you guys can see the difference. So fine would be a bit smaller, medium would be a bit larger, and as a result, it can take a bit more heat, it can take a bit more abuse, it can take stronger chemicals, but you still wanna treat it with love, care, and respect, especially if you have any type of curl pattern, it's going to need more moisture. Most of your heads of hair will fall in this range, but it doesn't account for certain things. So even though we're touching on all this, this still doesn't account for porosity, dryness, protein overload, there are several different factors, but I definitely wanna make sure you guys understand how this goes. If you're using something on fine hair, I would highly suggest using less alcohol, using less oils, things like that. Everything that you're doing, do less of it. So if you're curling, curl it less. If you're putting heat on it, use a lesser temperature. If you're putting product, use less product. Everything's either going to weigh it down or cause it to be damaged. So you just be careful with fine hair. Medium texture, you're gonna find that you need a bit more of a heavyweight product. Things like your cream sprays, things like that can be great for this hair type. But you'll also find that it can take a bit more abuse. So a little bit more product, but also can take more abuse. So slightly elevated temperature, things like that. You'll find that the temperature that easily works for fine hair does not as easily work for medium hair. So you might want to increase it by maybe 10 to 20 degrees. You'll see a big difference in terms of how that goes. A lot of times with fine hair, depending on how fine, you could start as low as 280 degrees and go up to maybe 340 degrees pretty safely. From there, I would just lightly ease your way up. Usually what I tell people is the lowest temperature that your hair will respond to, do that, okay? Then from there, we have coarse hair. Now, coarse hair is going to be the largest of the three. And basically this one is going to take the most abuse. You can have coarse hair, whether your hair is straight and silky, whether it is wavy, whether it is coily, is able to take quite a bit more abuse. And what that means is each of the strands is larger. So of course, this does not account for density either, but this does account for the size of the trees in your forest. So not how many trees are in your forest, but the size of those trees. So basically, you've got fat trees in your forest, you've got skinny trees in your forest. Now you could have a lot of fat trees or you could have a little bit of fat trees. You could have fine hair and have a lot of trees in your forest. So you could have high density, but fine hair. There's several different factors. Even if your hair feels thick to you to the touch, it doesn't mean that the individual strands are. So that's why I'm telling you guys, flyaways, breakage, things like that are more prone with fine hair. Now with more coarse hair, you'll notice if you're doing chemicals, it takes a bit more of an aggressive chemical to get it done. If you're using heat, it takes a bit more of an aggressive heat to get it done. If you're needing to moisturize, it takes a little bit more of a heavier moisture to get it done. And it takes a lot more product than say a head of fine hair. So you always wanna make sure you're catering things to your texture or your fabric of hair, because when it comes down to it, if you have coarse hair and you're using products for fine hair, you're going to be more prone to frizz, to dryness, to unruly, out of control hair, and that's ultimately going to lead to breakage. At the same time, if you have fine hair and you're using something for coarse hair, there's a good chance that you're going to look like you need to bathe, your hair is always looking oily, super thin, or it's just being weighed down and loaded up with way too much product, you'll tend to have buildup on your hair, which can also lead to breakage. That's why it's important to know these things. So I hope that helps to kind of break down the whole texture conversation for people a bit more. If you have any further questions, let me know by leaving them down in the description box or the comment box below. Until next time, you guys, I'll see you later. Take care, God bless, and stay glam. You know I love you, boo. Bye. Make sure to follow us on Instagram at GetGlamFam for more behind the scenes content. Post from hair down to family posts like this one here with Zelina and myself, or even posts like this here with Allison and the girls in their little matching outfits. We have all sorts of stuff on there that you may actually love. Be sure to check us out.